Tables that have decorations on them. Go in, spread out, sit with who you like. Just find a table with the decoration on it, please. Good morning. Come on in, pick a table. Okay, come on in, pick a seat. Any table that you would like that has a decoration, feel free to spread out. We're using the entire cafeteria. Don't feel like you have to sit on top of each other. May not be a good idea. Graduation is less than 10 days away. Just gonna say that. Sit next to someone, spread out. We got a whole other half of the cafeteria over here. Whole other half. Just because you sit on this side doesn't mean you're gonna get to the food faster, I promise. Come on in, find any seat you would like. Please spread out though. We're trying to maintain some sense of social distancing. Graduation is less than 10 days away. We all want to see you there at 9 o'clock in the morning and not at home on your couch. Graduation is less than 10 days away, and I'm sure you all want to attend in person, not at home on your couch. And even if you don't want to attend, your parents want you to attend. So I'm just saying, think about who you're sitting with. We're also live on Facebook right now, so any of your My School Online or other friends who are at home are watching. Okay, the next thing is, I just want to say is there's an index card and a pencil at every table. So what I need you to do is write down the first and last name of every person at that table in a way that we can read later, okay? So just your first and last name. Come on in, find a seat. Okay, again, I'll make the announcement one more time. At your table is an index card and a pencil. You need to have everybody's name that's at the table, first and last name, please. And is it a good time to be funny? Okay, so just really quick, your name. So what's going to happen here in about 2 minutes is we're going to get started. I'll wait for you. Okay, so what's going to happen is here in just a few minutes, we're going to get started with just like the little presentation part of the event. So anybody who's watching at home can do that and then they don't have to sit and watch you guys eat, okay? And then we will be getting in the serving line for breakfast. You will be dismissed by table. So Ms. Hunt will come around and collect your card and verify your names, and then you'll be dismissed for table, okay? And Ms. Polaris will help her with that as well. And then you'll go through the line and come back and eat. In this corner over here, there's some balloons. If you want to take pictures, you're free to do that. And then once we see everyone's kind of wrapping up eating, we'll send you on your way back to class, okay? So I'm going to say one more time, because I still feel like people aren't listening very well. You have to fill out the index card, okay? So this morning, we want to say congratulations in the weirdest year of everyone's life, the second weirdest year of everyone's life, you get to graduate high school, which says a lot about all of you that you're here and you're graduating, because it's been really weird. But we want to walk through and talk about a few things, but the first thing we want to do is your class president, Mackenzie, has bestowed a gift upon your class, and she's spent probably the last month coordinating this for you guys, so we want to go ahead and let you see that.
Pick out the one that works best for you.
So the track you start out on might feel like
drive a few more before you are done.
And now, with your eyes on your new destination, start up your wheels and roll out of the seat.
On your journey, you'll make plenty of stops in deep river valleys and on high mountaintops.
Some will surprise you, and some will be planned. And you'll roll through each one safe after that.
You'll go through tunnels, alone in the dark, and you'll wish for a light, or even a spark.
You might be sad, or a little bit scared, and wish your track was one that you shared.
So here's some advice to help ease your doubt. The track you took in must also go up.
So set yourself and just tomorrow going. Before you know it, some light will be showing.
And then you'll be through heading to a new place. You'll be less uncertain in the next tunnel you face.
Sometimes you'll look up and see planes in the sky and you'll think to yourself, I wish I could fly.
You'll feel stuck on the track and think, I wish that was me.
Claim my wish, it is not in the air, saying I want to travel like that train down there.
The cars will watch as you speed right along, and they'll say to each other, look how fast and how strong.
Don't worry about not being a car or a plane, just enjoy the trip. You'll take the train.
Don't be afraid to toot your own horn. If you need to be heard, for there are people to mourn.
Or if being yourself just makes you so proud that you want to share it and see me fly.
You'll follow your track, the twists of your bends,
and the split at the new spots, and the big up of your friends.
They'll all come aboard with smiles and greetings.
You'll have such great times with your people in your dreams.
On the days when you're sad and you're down,
speak up and ask for a push or a tell.
That's what friends do, so don't be afraid.
You do the same if someone needs a name.
You might arrive at some places you will never visit.
And look for new friends. But they won't come aboard.
So you'll have to head out, creaking in the road, setting out walking in on your track all the way
around. Try to remember that the coverage is so wide.
Full of all kinds of people with their own friends to ride.
Just stay true to yourself as you travel.
With no second guessing and no looking back.
Once you're on the right track, you'll probably say, this one is mine. I'm here to stay.
Try to enjoy the track and
cheese. Stop now and then to take in the views.
If you rush forward as a general rule, before you arrive, you can run out of fuel.
Don't work too much, but save up some strength. That way, every day, you can travel great lengths.
You'll need your strength of a days when you're stuck, or tired, or sad, or just out of luck.
When your belief in yourself is in need of a cure,
and your I think I can doesn't sound quite so sure.
That's when to push and to strive and to strain, to show the world you're not a given dust train.
And you're wise if you know that doing your best means that sometimes you should just slow down and rest.
Speeding through the whole journey might be a song.
So slow down today and happy tomorrow.
There's more about life that you'll learn if you don't, because figuring things out on your own helps you grow.
Just trust in yourself and you'll climb every hill. Say, I think I can. And you know what? You will!
So thank you, Mackenzie. That was wonderful. And we are going to post it on our school YouTube channel, so if you missed part of it and you want to rewatch it, or if you're watching at home and you couldn't see it or hear it very well, it will be on the YouTube channel, and Mr. Williams will let you guys know via social media when that's left, okay? All right, so before we leave, we have a couple other things that we want to do. We want to recognize our unusually weird prom court this year. Our prom court minus the prom. So first, I just want to recognize everyone who was on prom court before we announce who the king and queen were by your votes. So for the prom court queen nominees, we have Ellie Gorgeous. So when I call your name, stand up. Alexis Duong. Harley Green. Summer Johnson. Alexis Story. And for King, we have Matthew Bauer. Thomas J. Crawford. Cody Flynn. anything game. Okay, so I need a drum roll. Drum roll. Your 2021 prom queen is Alexis Thorne. So this year, in unprecedented times, we have an unprecedented issue. We have two kings. There was a tie. Right split down the middle. So I will recognize the first prom king, and that is Thomas J. Crawford. And the second prom king is Matthew Ballard. Come on up, Matthew. Since you're the only one here, you're the only one that gets the loop. Congratulations. Here for Ann Club High. Congratulations. Okay. If you were on prom court and you were a lady and did not get your sash, please see me because I have a couple extra. I think a couple people missed out on picking up from my office. All right, I just want to make a couple of announcements that I need everyone in here to hear because we don't get all of you together at the same time before we start releasing tables to eat. The first is Tuesday, January, no, just kidding, Tuesday, May 25th at 9 a.m. we're having graduation practice. It is very important that you are here and on time so you know how we're going to line up and how things are going to go. It's very different this year, so it's like if you've been to graduation before, it's not the same because, and it's not like last year, it's a whole new show for you guys, okay? So don't just make assumptions that, oh, I don't need to go because I already know, because I assure you don't know, okay? So make sure you're here at 9 a.m. We're going to be in the gym and we're going to do like a walkthrough lineup. Later that day, starting during fifth and sixth period, you will be released to come down to get your cap and gown, to collect your tickets for graduation for your four guests, if you've paid your fees. So if you've not, you need to take care of that before Tuesday so you can get tickets for your guests to attend, okay? So you'll be checking in and getting those at that time. Then we're going to do a parade on campus, so a senior walking parade, okay? A clap out that day. So make sure you're here, like if you're off campus, come back around fifth period time frame, all right? Because we're just gonna call you down by a couple letters at a time so it's not too crazy in the gym. That's on Tuesday. So mark your calendars, make sure you're here. The second thing is, if you have not taken your district finals, please make sure you see Ms. Cooper in the testing suites to do that, okay? It is important that you finish those. You can see her today, right? Today, she's doing it today and tomorrow, I believe. So make sure you do that, because you have to be done by tomorrow to final out your grades. And the last thing is I'll show you. So as we go to exit later, you will all be receiving one of these. Compliments of Miss Moon. So let's thank her for that. You're the first class to receive a shirt for free. Okay. So as we go to leave, make sure you see us to get your size. We guesstimated, I think we did an okay job. And we want you to wear this shirt to the picnic so we can try to get some photos there, okay? Since we had some photo issues this year, all right? Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start dismissing. Ms. Hunt is going to grab a couple of tables and so is Ms. Valeris, collect your card. And she'll tell you, you need to line up along the left side and go through the receiving line and come back around to your table so we don't have a clog up. Also, the students are here to serve you, so please don't touch or grab anything unless they tell you to, okay? Because there's a couple things you have a choice, either or, and there's some things you can pick from, but they're here in a professional manner to help you, so make sure you let them do that, all right? So if you came in late, remember that we have to have everybody's name on a card at the table you're at in order for you to be released, okay? Does everyone understand? And come back to the seat you're in. That's the other pitch. Come back to the seat you're in. This is your seat for the morning. Go ahead. Also, there's a slideshow learning on the front that was made for you by Anastasia Kalarakis. It has everybody in the class. And those that submitted pictures or had senior pictures are in there as well. So you're all in here. If you received an invitation, tonight is Senior Night of Excellence, so please make sure you come back with your families at 6 p.m. in the gym.
I'm so upset. I dropped my
Did you?
I'm so upset. Hey folks, how we doing over there? Doing good? Wave to the camera. Wave. Thank you. Good morning, folks. How we doing?
Good
morning. Enjoying your senior breakfast?
No, I'm getting.
I know you cooked last year. Good morning, folks. Good morning.
Hi. Can you show me really quick? Mom, I love you.
Good morning, how are we doing, gentlemen? How are we doing? Good morning.
Amazing.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good
morning, Miss Hunt.
Good morning.
Jason, aka Hunt.
I don't even know my own name.
Right. Hey,
gentlemen. Good morning, how are we doing? Seniors, about to graduate. Good morning. How are you? Do you like your sign?
Yes, I do.
Good. Good morning. Good morning, seniors. It's almost graduation time. Morning. Our prom queen right there. Hello, Miss Duong. Miss Abby. Hold on. Oh, gosh.
Hi, Mom.
Hello.
Hi, Abby's mom.
Hello. Okay. Recognize me. Good morning. How are we doing?
Hola.
Good morning. Thank you.
Where's Miss Angel?
She's not.
To really quick make a couple of announcements, because we're going to close out Facebook Live so that anybody who's watching there doesn't feel like they need to keep watching. The first announcement I want to make is I want to thank Chef and all of our culinary students for providing us this awesome breakfast. And I would also like to remind you of those things again really quickly. Graduation practice, 9 a.m. Meet at the gym on the 25th, which is Tuesday of next week. Cap and gown pickup will start between 5th and 6th period, okay? If you need to pay your senior fees to get your tickets between now and then, please do so. Also, for all of our students and families watching at home, we will have your t-shirts for you to pick up at graduation practice. So make sure you see myself, Ms. Valeris, and Ms. Angie's, and we'll make sure we get that in your hands, because every senior has a shirt, okay? So thank you for tuning in this morning. We miss you guys.